Hello, you guys, and welcome to Designer How. Today, we'll go over a quick method for achieving impressive speed ramp transitions with motion blur. Let's go. You want to have your clips or chopped up sections in place, select them all, then right click and choose Nest. This will allow us to edit the whole as a single clip and make life easier on us. Make sure you are satisfied with the editing of all clips, though, because once they become one, you'll never, ever be able to separate them again. Just joking. Daddy. You can cut them loose at any time. We want to go and seek out the section where the scenes split. Then we'll use the arrow buttons to skip to the exact frame where they separate. Now right-click on the FX icon on the clip and select Time Remapping and Speed. Drag out the channel for a better view of the speed signature. This is where we can alter the speed of the clip, and it will create keyframes. To edit the speed signature, or the rubber band, as Adobe likes to call it, you can use the pen tool. But I prefer just holding the control button and clicking the band. We'll go ahead and create two keyframes on both sides of our intersection. This is where the ramping is going to take place. Drag the line upward to increase its speed, and as you see, the clip gets shorter. Between 6 and 800 is fine for this section, but you can decide for yourself what kind of speed is best suited to your project. Use these markers to drag out the lines and we'll have our ramp. Then drag in the curve handles on each ramp to make the transitions between keyframes even smoother. As you see, we already have some nice ramp action going on here, but I will boost the speed a bit. Very nice. I'll repeat the process on the other ones, and we have our ramps. To make it feel more natural, though, we will add some motion blur. The fastest way to do this is through a plugin called Real Smart Motion Blur. That one does cost money, though, so if you're too broke for that, you may skip ahead and I'll show you another way. Click New Item and select Adjustment Layer. Toss that on the timeline above your clip. Go to Effects and type in RSMB, then drag the effect onto your new layer. The plugin will blur movement automatically, super easy. It's already blurry, but I'll increase the blur a little. I like that quite a bit. Now, if you don't own Real Smart, you'll want to create an adjustment layer as well. Then go to Effects, type Directional, and throw the directional blur onto the layer. Select your clip, and you'll see the speed keyframes next to the effect control panel. Direction we'll put around 90, and we'll activate the blur keyframe. We will sync the blur keyframe to go in line with the speed keyframes. 0 for the outsides of each speed ramp. Then somewhere between 6 and 12 for the insides. Hold Alt, drag a keyframe, then release to copy it and all its values. This should speed up your workflow. As you can see, the blur now coincides with the ramps. For an extra smooth feel, right-click the keyframes and let them ease in and out of the action. And this is the result. Pretty neat. Well, guys, that is really all there is to it. I hope this was helpful. Please like and subscribe, and we will catch you all on the next one.